Well, the first thing to make out of the office of the citizen is to get the citizens to see that the government is not working because you are not working. People tend to not be so responsible. People like blaming others for their failure. So, for instance, all the failures in Nigeria, everybody is convenience to dump it on Tinubu. All the failures in Enugu is convenience to dump it on the governor there. All the failures in Anambra is convenience to dump it on Soludo. But that's not the honest truth. The truth is that all the components of the society are failing, including those of us. There is nowhere in the world. It's just that people live in fantasy land. Anywhere you see democracy working, whether it's in America, whether it's in the UK, whether it's in France, whether it's in India, people, it's working because people are working it. I'll give you an instance. Do you know that it's not even up to 3 or 4 months? And what I'm saying, you can read it up, it's on the news. It's not up to 3 or 4 months that people were protesting in the UK, close to London. And it's actually in London that people were protesting. They were protesting police brutality on cats and stray dogs. Why were they protesting and shouting and blocking streets and carrying placards that policemen were dealing unfairly with stray cats and stray dogs? Here in Nigeria, police is dealing brutally with citizens, but people will not demand. And you will ask yourself, what happens? But we protested, we were harmed. It happens. Look, go and watch the history of protests in the United States. History of protests, especially the movement that this man pioneered, Martin Luther King. They were arrested, they were killed, they were assassinated, they were unleashed. Anywhere you see people protesting, initially the government starts by responding with punitive, arresting, and then if you persist, you will wear the government out. And let me say this on your platform. What the government is doing is an advanced level of mind manipulation. When you tell people, come out and protest, they will tell you what happened to Endsars. You see the people killed. We were a part of the Endsars, as you rightly know. Look, we still mourn the people that were killed in Ever Valley, in Enugu there. We still mourn the people because they were killed. People were killed in Enugu. It's not just in Lagos that people were killed. People were killed around the country, but Lagos caught the attention of the public. And when you ask people, come out and protest, or they say, oh, what happened to Delegiwa? What happened to Ever Valley? What happened in Lekki Toll Gate? If you come out, you'll be killed. And let me tell you this for free. More people have died just this month alone in the hand of preventable death situation than the government has killed between 1960 and now. At every given month in Nigeria, more people die because they can't see oxygen in the hospitals than the even military government. All the people that the government have killed from the time Nigeria got independence to this moment, more people die because they can't find oxygen in the hospital than the government has killed as a result of public protests. More people die as a result of bad governance that they do in the hands of an oppressive government. Even Abacha's government, Buhari's government, Babangida's government, call all of them. All the people they killed, cumulatively or arrested or sent to exile, cumulate them. The number is not up to the number of women who die giving birth to children because governance services are not there. The number of people who die because they cannot afford 3 square meals. Go to places, I won't mention them so that it will not seem as if I'm scapegoating. You go to places, you see people literally slumping on the road. People languishing in hospitals because they can't afford. People are dying because of healthcare issues that 3,000 can solve. People die because of malaria now because they cannot afford 3,000 naira malaria drugs. And more people are dying. When you tell these people, go out and protest, they tell you government will kill them. But malaria is killing you because you can't afford it. So what you see here is an advanced mind manipulation. Look, the government cannot kill all of us. More people have died in Enugu in the hands of unknown gunmen than they can die in the hands of government killing people. So when you tell people protest, they tell you what happened to Endsars. Between Endsars and now, the people have died more than, but people don't take cognizance of these deaths. What they tell you is, oh, I'll be arrested. Oh, there is no prison that is large enough to contain all Nigerians. In fact, there is no prison that is large enough to contain 10% of Nigerians. I shock you. There is no prison that is large enough to contain 5% of Nigerians. But what you have is a docile and lethargic population. And so what the government does is that it kills one or two people and then everybody runs back home. No. Kill all of us. Let's see. And so when we begin to see that people will die regardless, that's the way I operate. Whether you die in the hands of a soldier's bullet, or you die in prison, or you die from malaria, or you die in the hands of a unknown gun, you will still die. Death is death. So why don't we live like kings? Why don't we live honorably? Why do we want to wait for the government to subject us to peasants, and we die like peasants, unsung, uncelebrated, our death is meaningless? The person who died today, between the time we started this program and now, people have died because they can't afford malaria drugs, anti-malaria drugs. Those people, their death is meaningless. If you now tell them the next day, come out, let us demand, they will say they will die. Yes, you stayed in your room and malaria killed you because you can't afford food and you can't afford drugs. And you don't want to act in a way that will change that for you. So when we tell people organize and protest, the excuses are untenable. Untenable, and they are done out of an irrational fear that is inexplicable, that doesn't have any substance, and that is what they have used to hold us down. Even if Lekki happens 10 more times, we will still be demanding, we will still be protesting until we get it right, because people die more in the hands of bad governance than they do in the hands of an oppressive government.